viewers, welcome to the next video of Python programming language series. In this video, we'll be discussing more about arrays present in Python. There are four types of arrays which are more commonly used in Python programming language. They are list, tuple, set, and dictionaries. Let's discuss each of them one by one. Let's get started.
So let's launch the Jupyter lab. Let's get into a notebook. So it has created an untitled notebook for us. We can save it with a meaningful name, arrays in Python, because we are going to see about arrays in Python. And before that, there are some rules to declare a variable in Python. A variable can only have alphabets and underscore and the numerical numbers, and other than that it shouldn't have anything. And the variable should not start with a number. For example, I'm giving 3a equal to 5. I'm just trying to assign the number 5 to the variable 3a here. So it is showing that it is invalid. So you cannot start a variable name with a number. And I'm trying to start with the underscore here, 3a equal to 5. I can do that. So, and apart from that, you can have alphabet capital A to capital Z, small a to small z, and integers 0 to 9, and underscore. These are the characters that can be present in a variable. Apart from that, Python doesn't support any other special characters in the variable name. And I just wanted you to know this variable naming convention in Python. So, for example, I am trying to give a star b equal to 5. I'm just trying to declare a variable called a star b. Basically, I'm having a special character of star here. So let's see. It is saying that can't assign to an operator. So basically, the star has been converted into an operator by Python. So the Python doesn't understand this statement. So this is the variable naming convention. I just wanted you to know. And so let's get into arrays in Python. First, we are going to discuss about set. Set is nothing but kind of an array, and it can store multi data types also. And it is unordered and it is unindexed. So you cannot access the set using any index. It is not subscriptable, basically. So also, the set is unordered, right? So what do you mean by unordered is the way of storing the set will not be same as the way you have declared. For example, I'm declaring this set sample. This is how you declare with the curly braces. Banana, apple, orange, papaya, so basically I have declared one set here. So I am trying to print this set. As you can see, when I printed the set, the papaya came in front. But when I declared, it was the last item in the set. So basically, it is unordered, and it is not indexed with anything, and you cannot subscript the set. For example, I will try to access the second element in this sample set by using 0 and let's say the second element can be accessed by giving 1, because generally we will access the arrays in this method. So yes, it is not subscriptable. So you can see that error here. If you want to add any element to a set, you can do the set sample dot add function. I'm going to add Arjun, let's say, and I am printing set sample. So you can see that Arjun is added here. Also, you can note that Arjun is not appended as the last element. Since it is unordered, it is random. It is stored as a fourth element in our example. Also, if you want to remove anything, for example, I'm going to remove orange from this set. I have used the remove method. Set sample. If you see, there is no orange in the set. Also, if I am trying to remove which is not present in the set, this remove method will throw you an error. So now that the orange is already removed, the orange is not present in the set right now. I am trying to remove it again. It will throw me an error. For this, there is another method called discard. In that, if you are trying to remove an element which is not present in the set, it will not throw you an error. Set sample dot discard orange. So it didn't throw me an error. For this, we will use discard method. Also, in set, it is not allowed to enter any duplicates. For example, I'm going to give dog here. So set sample, it will only store dog. So the duplicates will automatically get removed. And also, if you want to combine multiple sets, set sample 2, I'm declaring one more set here, cat. You can combine both the sets by dot union of set sample underscore 2. So it has basically combined both the sets and returned one new set. So and these are about set, and these are the things I just want to tell you about set. And moving on to list. List is unlike set, list can be indexed, it is ordered, and it will allow you duplicates also. For example, I am going to declare a new list sample. You can give in square brackets in order to declare a list. Cat, Dom. So it has created a list for me. List can be subscripted. So you can, for example, I'm going to refer the third element. So I'm giving number 2. 0, 1, 2. So it has returned me the third element of the list. Now I'm going to tell you how to access list in a range. For example, if I want to print everything in a list, I can simply give colon and it will print everything in a list. You can give lower limit and upper limit of the things you need to print in a list. You can give like, for example, if I want to print the first two elements, I will give 0 as a lower limit and 2 as upper limit. It will print me the first two elements. So if you think of it as an index, 0th index, first index will get printed, but the second index it will not print. So basically whatever we give, the lower limit is included and the upper limit is not included. So, and also if I want to print the last element of the list, I can give -1, so it will print me the last element, which is Tom here. So this is called negative indexing. In negative indexing, you can print like -1 as a last element, -2 is a last but second element, -3 is last but the third element. As you can see, the last but second element is cat. Last but the third element, which is our first element, also it is dog. If I want to add any new elements to a list, I can simply give append orange. I'm going to print list sample. So you can see that orange has been appended into a list as a last element. And if you want to insert the new element in a specific position, we can give list sample dot insert method. You can give the position here. I'm going to insert as a second element the apple. So let me print the list once again. As you can see, the apple has been inserted as a second element of a list here. So if you want to remove any specific element from the list, you can give list.remove cat. So I have removed cat from the list. As you can see, there is no cat in the list. So in order to combine two lists, you can give list sample. I'm going to create another list here. This sample which has cat and fruits. So if I want to combine both these lists, you can give list.sample.extend list of sample 2. So now I am going to print list sample here. So basically it has extended the list sample with the list sample 2. It has appended the list sample 2 elements in with the list sample. And if you want to copy a list into another list, I'm going to create list view equal to list sample. Now it has created a copy of list sample to list new. So I'm going to print list new. List new is having these elements, and if I am trying to modify list new, it will also affect list sample, because basically we have just created a copy of list sample into a new list, list new. List new dot remove Tom. I'm going to remove the Tom element here. So in list new, it is expected that Tom will not be there. Similarly, I am trying to print list sample So as you can see, list sample is not it's also not having a dump. So basically whatever the change we make in the copy, it is also affects the original list also. So if you don't want this to happen, and if you want to create a new copy of a list, and if you don't want to disturb the original list, you can use the built-in method, which is list.copy sample.copy. So basically it will create a copy here, list new underscore 2. I'm printing this. Now I'm going to make changes to this new list. I'm going to remove Apple. So let's see the original list, which is list underscore sample. It is still having Apple, but let me see the new list. It is not having Apple. So the original data is not modified here. If you use this copy built-in method, if you want to combine two lists, you can do like list new 3 equal to list new 2 plus list sample. I'm adding these two lists into a new list called list new 3. So I'm going to print a list new of 3. So it is having both elements, and also you can see that the list is allowing us to store duplicates. Dog is repeated multiple times. You can check the length of a list using a len function, len of list new 3. So you can see that the length is returned as 9. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 lists, 9 items in the list. So it comes very handy when you are using for loops, and if you don't know the length of a new list, you can use this function and it will return you the length. And if you want to know whether an item is present in a list or not, you can give if dog in list new 3, print, I'm going to print yes. I'm just checking whether the dog element is present in the list new 3, and if it is there, I am printing yes. So yes, the element dog is present in the list. And, if you want to sort the list, you can do dot sort method list new 3. I'm just printing the list here, so I'm going to sort now, new 3 dot sort. So list new 3. So now you can see that it is sorted. Now it has sorted alphabetically. And if you want to sort the list in a descending order, you have to give list new 3 dot sort reverse equal to true. So it will sort in a reversing order, which is nothing but in descending order. Yes, you can see that the list is sorted in a descending order. It starts from O and ends with A. Let's talk about tuples now. Tuples are immutable, which means you cannot change the tuple, and tuples are subscriptable also. Tuple new and tuples are ordered. Tuple new 1. I'm going to create a tuple using this brackets apple cat dog and 34. Yeah. Tuple new one. It's similar to list. You can access using a subscript. I'm going to access the second element. So I'm doing one. You can see that cat is being returned. And tuple is not changeable. So I'm trying to add an item. Tuple of 0, 1, 2, 3. I'm going to add a new item in the fourth position. I'm going to add orange. So, tuple object does not support item assignment. Yeah, you cannot add anything in a tuple once it is created. Yeah. And also, tuple will allow you to have duplicates just like lists. I'm going to create a new tuple. Cat. I'm going to print it. So you can see that there are two cats. So it is allowing duplicates. How to join multiple tuples is plus new 2. So it has created a new tuple by joining multiple tuples. So you can see that cat of tuple new 2 tuple is joined with the tuple new 1, and it has returned us the new tuple for us. Now let's see about Python dictionaries. With respect to Python dictionaries, it is unordered, and there is no order in which the data will be stored in the memory. And Python dictionaries are indexed. So basically, I'm going to declare a new dictionary here using curly braces, and the data will be stored in a key value format. So the key will act as an index for it. I'm going to give fruit colon values apple. Now I'm going to give animal dog. So if you see here, the fruit is a key, apple is a value, animal is the key, dog is a value, and flower is a key, and rose is a value. So if you want to get the value of fruit, you can give fruit, and the value will be returned as apple. If you want to check whether any key is present in the dictionary or not, you can give like if animal in dictionary print yes. So the animal key is present in the dictionary new, so it has printed the yes. If you want to add any new elements, it is not like tuple. You can change the dictionaries. If I want to add sports equal to cricket, it is like the sports new key value key It is like for the key sports, a value cricket will be inserted in the dictionary. Dictionary new. So I have printed, you can see that sports cricket has been inserted. If you want to remove any value, you can give, I'm going to remove sports key from the dictionary. I can give del of dictionary new as sports. So now I'm going to print the dictionary once again. So as you can see, the sports is not present in the dictionary. And similar to lists, you can use the copy method in order to copy one dictionary to another dictionary. New underscore one. Dict new dot copy. So here a new dictionary will be created. Dict new one. So it is same as the list. And if I create another dictionary by simply assigning it, whatever changes we make in dictionary new one, it will also affect the original dictionary underscore new. So similar to list, you may want to use this copy in order to avoid affecting the original dictionary. So these are the arrays present in Python which are more commonly used.
Hey guys, thanks for watching the video, and I really think the video was very helpful to you. We have discussed a lot about the arrays present in Python, and in the next video we will be discussing about conditional statement and looping statements present in Python. Until then, see you, have a great day.